Good morning, angels.
Good morning,
Junelee. Zyr, Mira, Praise, I hope you're rested and ready for your first assignment. The story of a greater understanding of planetary motion could not be told if it were not for the work of a German mathematician named Johannes Kepler. Kepler was forced to an eventual realization that the orbits of the planets are not circles, but were instead the elongated or flattened circles that geometers called ellipses. Angels, your first mission is to explain and discuss Kepler's first law of planetary motion.
Let's begin the mission, shall we?
Time to discover this first law of planetary motion.
Allow me to begin with. In the early 1600s, Johannes Kepler proposed three laws of the planetary motion. Kepler was able to summarize the carefully collected data of his mentor, Tycho Brahe, with three statements that describe the motion of planets in a sun-centered solar system. Kepler's efforts to explain the underlying reasons for such motions are no longer accepted. Nonetheless, the actual laws themselves are still considered an accurate description of the motion of any planet and any satellite. Let's look further and explain the first law, or most commonly known as the law of ellipses.
The orbits of the planets are ellipses with the sun at one focus of the ellipse. There is no object at the other focus of a planet's orbit. An ellipse is a regular oval shape traced by a point moving in a plane so that the sum of its distances from two other points. As a planet in its elliptical orbit, its distance from the sun and speed vary. When an object moves around another object in an oval-shaped path, it is known to be revolving in an elliptical orbit. A planet moves most rapidly when it is nearest the sun or at perihelion. A planet moves most slowly when it is farthest from the sun, or at aphelion. All planets move around the sun in elliptical orbits, with the sun as one focus of the ellipse.
Each planet's orbit around the sun is an ellipse. The sun's center is always located at one focus of the orbital ellipse. The sun is at one focus. The planet follows the ellipse in its orbit, meaning that the planet-to-sun distance is constantly changing as the planet goes around its orbit. Kepler's first law is rather simple. All planets orbit the sun in a path that resembles an ellipse, with the sun being located at one of the foci of that ellipse. This first law is called law of ellipses.
In summary, each planet's orbit about the sun is an ellipse. The sun's center is always located at one focus of the orbital ellipse. The sun is at one focus. The planet follows the ellipse in its orbit, meaning that the planet to the sun's distance is constantly changing as the planet goes around its orbit.
Kepler and his theories were crucial in the better understanding of our solar system dynamics and as a springboard to newer theories that more accurately approximate our planetary orbits.
Kepler's law of planetary motion, first law explained. That's just the first law. What more about the others, Junelee?
Congratulations, angels! You've successfully explained Kepler's law of planetary motion, first law. Are you ready for more? This is Junelee's angels, full throttle. Zyr, Mira, Praise, I hope you're as delighted.
Planets are ellipses with the sun at one focus
In summary, each planet's orbit about the sun is an ellipse. The sun's center is always
again.